Hello there. So, this is. Wait, shit, I remember to do the thing. I did not remember to do the thing. I need to change the title of the stream because this is the second episode. So, where last we've left off, we were being chased around by a giant chap in a rather fetching bin bag outfit. He came at us with a flamethrower, so we shot him a bunch. Then he came at us with a rocket launcher and shot us a bunch. Also something to do with zombies, but that's not really important now, is it? Hello, Akatsuki. I can my baggage. So much loot, so little pocket. Oh, hey, Than, how are you? Swear to God, that giant burning building definitely wasn't anything to do with me. Keep right clicking because of the. Well, because I've been playing way too much of Valheim, probably. Kendo did deserve better, yeah. Then again, who didn't? Speaking in Latin, are you, eh? Well, are we? True to Kaiser. That is kind of tempting. But I think I'll leave the explosive rounds up here for now. Actually, Barry does appear in this game. He gets at. He gets that pretty bad. God damn it. I just want to know who sells him these things. Eh, probably the merchant from 4. And dead. Oh, that is Brad, you're right. I don't know, they're all cops, they just ignore their names, they don't deserve them. Never get the hang of fighting these dickheads. To it. I need the ammo, so you give me bullet. Oh, Nemesis totally just like jumped down the RPG off a roof. Like that. Bad time to reload. Might be canon in that game that Umbrella gave him the guns, but I prefer my personal headcanon. He was given, bought the guns off the merchant from Resident Evil 4. Who is actually just Kendo in disguise. I might not be dead, but I was very close to becoming a Jill sandwich.
Jill, you there? I think I know how to slow that fucker down. Head back towards the station.
And lead him right to you?
It's okay. Trust me.
Oh man, this neighborhood has gone downhill. Stars are basically cops, and cops are bastards, so you know. This is actually one of the less reprehensible things Umbrella is up to. That's the biggest tragedy in this entire game. Those crabs get burnt. They were so delicious. Friendly advice, which I'm sure will be useful in your day-to-day lives. Shooting a fuel tanker like that doesn't actually cause a big explosion.
Carlos, I know we didn't get off to a great start. Thanks for the save.
Hey, you saved my ass first. You're a hell of a lot braver than me.
What matters is that we can get everyone out of the city now.
Yeah. Now you'll be safe.
I'm sure this is going to end well for all involved.
What about you?
From the sound of it, I won't be catching the train.
Why not?
Now there'll be new orders.
Execute order 66.
Fine by me.
I don't think Nemesis asks other people for tentacle hentai. I think the dude just makes it himself. He's a producer, not a consumer. We should all try to be more like him.
Good work. Your reputation is well deserved. Get inside. The subway's about to leave. Carlos, Tyrell, you have your orders. You need to go back out into the city and find Nathaniel Bard.
This isn't the last man out of town, right?
Do not worry. Once the civilians are safe, the train will be back.
It's all right. You go on ahead. I'm not gonna die on you, leave you in a cold, cruel, Carlos's world.
Okay.
You'll need to find this scientist. His vaccine research could save us all.
You see?
Kendo's gun shop is left to save.
The only life that matters is your home.
Good luck. Let's go!
You don't really think Vince or Pusher like Barton is still alive, do you?
I haven't done good authority. Why? Are you worried about teammates? Something else. Funny how brainless zombies can ambush a platoon like that. Funny the gate was locked. Don't you think?
Curse your sudden but entirely expected betrayal.
Get off my train, shitbird!
Right, so I'm sure he's definitely dead this time. Also, rest in peace, a third of the acceptable members of the Umbrella murder assault rifle team.
Subway's gotta be clear of the city by now.
Along with your hot date?
Nah, she's not like that. Hell, she's not like anybody.
Keep your head screwed on, Romeo. This is the police station.
You sure? Looks like a cemetery to me.
You're dead and I'm not. That's hilarious. I hope that guy survives and has a nice happy ending.
Shit, it's locked. You stay on the door. I got this fucker. Come get some.
I'm so good at aiming and shooting and shit.
Still worth a damn, then barge in the Star's office. Let's find him and take him into custody.
Custody? I thought this was a rescue.
Carlos, take a look at this. I've located the Star's office. Remember, Bard had access to Umbrella's darkest secrets. He knows we'll try to keep him under our thumbs.
So this search and rescue mission is really more like find and detain. Good to know.
I'll open the shutter so you can get through.
You stay here and find out what's been going on here at the station.
Call you if I find anything. Hey! Be careful.
Yeah. You too.
Need an ID card to open up the box.
Need a Star's ID to crack this open.
If I knew impersonating a police officer wasn't a crime. Oh wait, Brad was Stars. It's not that I'm bad at killing zombies, Akatsuki. I'm a pacifist. Beep.
What the hell was that thing?
Got wrecked by a liquor. Hey, don't be a dick to helicopter pilots.
We go.
They're the bravest men in video games because they're the ones who are guaranteed to crash and burn. Lost your leg privileges, mate. Yes, I will take all the loot I can find, given that I'm sure nobody else is going to need it in, say, a second Resident Evil game.
Something real nasty in here. I don't know what it is,
I do like to cripple people. You should be thankful that I found a safe outlet for it. Ah, the US healthcare system. What a hilarious thing it is. Oh, hey, tactical scope. Now I can actually see what I'm shooting at. This is unlikely to help my accuracy. So I need to get the battery from the safety deposit room. Long shot if I remembered that from the last game anyway. Some dank kush. Cool.
Shit. Locked.
Bullets in here. All right, just down there. I can use these for murders.
Things, I'd be set.
Fatal Frame reference. All I need now is some green herbs and I'll be set. Save as Captain Best Boy.
I
What about a keyboard? I got that reference.
Carlos, the Star's office is up ahead.
Copy that.
It's a reference to that time I murdered somebody and beat him over the head with a keyboard. Pretty sure this one's Cap. Yeah, guess I mixed that up. House of the Dead is a really weird franchise.
Oh, for fuck's sake, why is it blocked?
Ah, so we've already got the bomb in place, we just need the batteries. First, we must loot the room.
Better not.
I knew one of these was Cap. You gotta love Locker Corps. Swear to God, are these floor corpses just completely undodgeable? DCM. Good to die. Fuck you, you get throat punches. Six and nine. But yeah, I like this section of the game because it's basically just whoops, all call forwards or call backs, depending on what order you're going in. casually walk away. Oh, hey, Amber. More bullet. If there were like half a dozen security guards like that in Raccoon City, there'd be no need for any of these games because the zombies would have all just got like arrested. Right. Little known fact. I've always wanted to blow up a police station. Oh my, lots of zombies. If it isn't the entirely foreseeable consequences of my own actions. Fucking ankle biters. It's America, so we can probably assume the sick leave policy is terrible. Alright, pal, one of us is going to have to move. That's a good boy. And now you get punched in the throat. And now I just take a quick jog.
Dr. Bard.
Trying to reach somebody.
Don't worry, we're gonna get you out of there. Just tell me where you are.
I'm trapped in a goddamn hospital surrounded by every kind of abomination. Look, just send in Stars. They're gonna know what to do.
Not negative. RPD's overrun too.
Then figure it out.
Be gone, thought, you say, Umbrella's not realizing that it is me who is the thought.
I am the only one who knows how to make the vaccine to stop the zombies. So you can either sit there with your dick in your hand or send somebody who's capable of getting me the hell out of here.
All right, dick in hand it is.
Already. Yeah, you would. You heard what he said. We can't turn him over to the company. That's not our call to make. That's Mikhail's call. And I'm going to check the computer, see if I can trace the doc's location.
This will take some time. Look around, see if you can find anything useful.
Ooh, 50 bullets. And now Brad can go in the trash where he belongs. Oh, wait, that was a stupid idea. Spoiler alert, Akatsuki. I've not actually played the original, so I just always trusted him 100%. I trust everyone.
Is that Jill in the front row?
Medical supplies, I'm sure nobody else will need them.
Yeah, what's up? Derail? Was anyone hurt?
Yeah, it's true, I don't trust you.
Oh, shit. What?
Yeah.
Joe, what happened?
Akatsuki, you're a very minor character that I only see after you're already dead or dying. And so Carlos rushes off to save Jill, riding on waves of horniness. Don't worry, I bet Captain Dickhead McBlonde Pants definitely made it. You don't kill off a villain like that in a train accident.
Carlos? Come in. Carlos? Damn it, I guess I'm out of range.
Let's see, what do we have here? Lots of herbs, lots of grenades. Oh. Landmine grenades. I bet I'm not going to be fighting something that runs in a very predictable pattern and is vulnerable to being blown up soon. Sort out my gear. Shotgun, grenade launcher, pistol, knife. Landmine rounds and my grenade launcher. Shotgun shells, pistol shells. Yeah, hopefully that'll see me through. Yeah, the Umbrella training manuals are kind of shit. It's just like, okay, here's our favourite weed blends. You just need gunpowder to make bullets, no need for shell casings or lead or anything like that. And landmines are useful if you shoot them out of your grenade launcher. See? That was a waste. No, I did actually manage to take out a few of them with that, so I guess it wasn't too bad. Yes, you've all lost your cranium privileges. Up the ladder to immediately be attacked by Watch-His-Face Mick, Nemesis dude.
Booker's still alive. I can't stay here.
Oh, but you totally could if you wanted to. Gotta loot the area. Wait a second. God damn it, I'm not equipped to loot the area because I've got too much crap in my pockets. Sigil, you totally can stay here, it's fine. Look. If I open the box, then I have to have a search warrant to say that I'm allowed to because I'm a cop. If I find the box already in pieces, well then I'm allowed to look into it. I bet this clock tower won't come up and be important later. You know what? Yeah, I'm going to be a tourist now. Ah, one of the locals. Hey you, where is the nearest bakery?
Bitch can't swim.
Ha.
Carlos, respond.
Yeah, what's up?
We didn't make it. The train derailed.
Derailed? Was anyone hurt?
No, everybody's dead. Mihail, everybody. Nikolai left us to die.
Wait, what?
What the fuck?
I'm pretty sure Little Licker is, a sex toy. Oh, hey. The local's back. Where's the bakery? No, not Chase. Où est la boulangerie? I can take him. God damn it, I didn't rise without ammo and just kept Oh my. What a completely untelegraphed path of action he's taking. I wonder if I'll be able to...
I'm gonna kill you!
Shout through the heart, and you're to blame. You give Umbrella Corps a bad name. Cause you're shit at... boss fights. Yeah, it probably is the Nemesis Parasite, but I don't know as many songs about that. This could be Parasite. God damn, this Nemesis is just running around doing fucking anime jump kicks. Top 10 anime showdowns right there. Ah, cutscene. Oh, look here, we've got somebody who's good for to watch Cats the movie. Some highfalutin city boy thinks he's better than Jennifer Aniston in frankly disturbing CGI costumery. Somebody who doesn't want to watch the death of Dame Judi Dench's career. Of course you watch Cats at 3 in the morning, that's the only time anyone's dumb enough to see it. Oh wow, a shitload of landmines. Those would have been useful if I'd actually spotted them during the thing. Yeah, well. Just gonna use one of them up so I can be in tip-top shape for what happens next. Oh, thank God I don't have to do the clock tower section. Don't worry about Nemesis, he's armless now. Oh, excellent. Good King Nick can save us. Good old Nick's going to be so disappointed. Spent half a day trying to figure out how to get around that portcullis. By the time he gets there to help Jill out, Carlos has already swooped in to save the day. I'm pretty sure Carlos is assuming she's been infected by the combination of being pale as shit and also having a nap for half a day in the middle of a zombie outbreak.
I'm gonna get you the vaccine. You're gonna be okay. I promise.
Ooh, more bullet.
Tyrell, where's Bard now?
Gotta be the lab in the back. Stay frosty, I'm on my way.
Copy. I'll go on ahead.
God damn soldier boy saying stay frosty, now I'm just imagining Carlos with frosted tips. It's always a good thing to have an assault rifle. Assault rifle means family. Family means no one gets left alive. Direct quote from the American version of Lilo and Stitch. Hey Nate, I've got a fire mixtape to drop here.
Dr. Bard, are you in there? I'm here to rescue you. Open the door.
No voice match found.
Voice match? What kind of sci-fi bullshit is this?
It's funny because Discord is a terrible system. It is really surprisingly bad for actually keeping in touch with people. Because whenever Billy starts streaming, I always get the message like way after it's already started. And now so does Billy. God, there's so much medical stuff just lying around here. Almost as if this was some kind of hospice or clinic. If only there was a word for such places. Oh well. Hey, they aren't people. Well, okay, technically they are people, but, like, I don't see them as people. Oh, great, my pockets are full of bullets and drugs. Just another day in the US of A. Now I'll probably have the chance to get back to the thing. It's not bigotry against the living impaired, because they're not living impaired. That's why I have to shoot them. If they were living impaired, they wouldn't be wandering around trying to pick fights and starting shit they can't finish. If you dickheads start getting up now, I'm going to be really pissed off with all of you. Ha. All these nurse and doctor types just like locked up the doors and then got dead. Ooh, more bullets. I'm not even going to question that, that's just how American hospitals are. Oh yeah, people who are infected with the disease are the worst. Like, if you've got the sniffles, don't come near me, I will blow your head clean off. And not in the sexy way either. Fun story. One of the reasons that in Sweden being gay or trans isn't classified as a disease anymore, because it used to be considered a mental illness back in the day. But it isn't anymore because all the gays just stopped turning up to work because they were too gay to work. Because, I mean, if it's an illness, you can take time off for it. Am I missing something blatantly obvious here? Ah, the linen room. I can use the linen to start mopping up. I don't think I passed by a weapon upgrade. I think the weapon upgrade's in the other section, which I couldn't get to from falling out of that particular window. So I'm going to come up here and jump out a different window. Because that's what smart people do. Oh, I thought for sure the weapon upgrade was... Yeah, so it's right here. But you see, I can't get here from where I jumped out of that window. Because I can't climb over there. Because Carlos... does not have hops, mad or otherwise. Oh, when did you get here? How do you like your kneecaps? Oh yeah, I totally did miss the key, like, got no excuse there. Ooh. What was that I caught a glimpse of? Is it perhaps a friend? Damn giant ninjas running around hiding. This isn't even the right way to go. Man, I bet if I got into the dispensary I could just, like, fill a briefcase with all their drugs and make a mint. Hey, you're still dead? Good, keep up the good work. Yeah. People are dumb about pull push doors, but also people are really bad at designing pull push doors. Okay, so this is obviously Mr. X's locker, you can tell by the hat. Don't know whose locker that is, but they clearly know how to party. Hey, my dude. Like, pro tip for any architects who are watching this stream. Point one, why? Point two, if you're making a door that can only be pushed open, don't put a handle on it so people can pull on it. Just put a push plate. Bad guy to get a hand job from. Reloading the silent killer. Loot up Deathclaw would be a great name for a band. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. Float like a good butterfly, get straight up murdered. Do not fucking condescend to me, game. Swear to God. And yeah, Mars was also streaming this, so it's probably from her stream. Reason doesn't sound like it works. I'll have to seduce him. Hey, good looking, I can see you don't skip leg day. I am bad at this. Like, because the thing is, I remember this section from the game before and I would just, like, breeze through it. But this time around, no, it turns out I can't do murders anymore. I'm not bigoted against zombies, I'm just heartbeat critical. I dodged that shit, fuck you. Honestly, murder the shit out of Nemesis, no problem. Get massacred by these fucking gamma hunters. Hmm. Fun fact, you actually catch more flies with vinegar than honey because fruit flies just go fucking nuts for the stuff. I'm going to feed an infinite amount of Carloses into this meat grinder if I have to, I swear to God. I will just bury this bastard under a pile of Carlos corpses. There are dozens of us. Door, why don't you open? There we go. Alpha this, beta that. I just want a grill for fuck's sake. Hey buddy, you having fun there? Cool. Oh man, you got sellotape? I just have to cover my wound in spray paint so it looks like I'm not dead. Fun fact, the healing sprays in this game are literally just like skin colour sellotape or skin colour spray paint. I'm gonna do something stupid to try and get this done quicker. God damn, but these dickheads are bullet sponges. I gotta get me some acid grenades. They call me the Kid Gunslinger, which is kind of weird since I'm like 32. That's a wild guess, Resident Evil nerds. Don't at me with how old Carlos actually is. Billy. Why would I pose with a brush as a gun when I could just pose in the mirror with a sword? Okay, this is a surgery room. Why is there assault rifle ammo and a hand grenade? Like, is this what America is? That was an embarrassing display. Ah well. Oh, hello friend. Didn't see you there. Anyway, if you'll excuse me, mate. Man, I would play the shit out of that. Because, like, if you're exploring a tomb with a musket, then you're going to have your bayonet fixed, like, all the time, right? Billy, you know I'm queer as fuck. There ain't a closet that can hold me, damn it. Because that's the thing about muskets, isn't it? They're slow to reload and pretty shit for that sort of... Well, especially if you're going for the old-time Napoleonic muskets where they've got really long bayonets. Hey, I can be gay and mean. In fact, I spend most of my time being gay and mean. God, if we're doing a Resident Evil style musket tomb exploring thing, then what kind of things are we going to give, like weapon attachments? Like, are we going to go for the actual historical stuff and give him, like, I don't know, a shiny new bayonet and a better ramrod and all that dull ass shit? Or are you going to be rolling around with a fucking Giselle with fucking laser sights?
Yeah.
Nine clockwise, three counterclockwise. Does he have a Fez? Of course he has a Fez. Do you have a Fez? Alright, you know what, fuck it. After I've completed this game, which hopefully shouldn't be a super long thing because these games are fairly short if you aren't doing all of the optional extras and shit. So once I'm done with this, I'm going to find a horror game in which you can run around with a musket. Because I give the people what they want, damn it. Huh. This Dr. Bard character seems like a bit of a dickhead. Thank you, Carlos. You've been drinking your respective women juice today.
guard's dead. He's been
worst
shot.
Case of suicide I ever did see.
Shit.
Two rounds to the back of the head.
I'm looking.
Well, look harder. There's gotta be a computer, right?
Oh man, that's really weird how the reflections appear and disappear in that door. So, asshole Dr. Bard.
Daniel Bard, September 29, 11 p.m.
Had a vaccine but wasn't going to use it for anybody apart from getting himself out.
And I hope and pray by making this recording and bringing the truth to light that I can restore some small shred of honor to my name. All of Raccoon City's suffering began with the release of a biological weapon known as the T-Virus. My employer, the Umbrella Corporation, engineered this virus. And they ordered my team to develop a vaccine, which we did. Now, I keep samples of this vaccine here in my office. The rest of it is stored underground. But those sons of bitches of the board, they want to destroy it. They don't want the world to know what they've done. So they're trying to erase all evidence that the virus ever existed. I'm not a fool. I know they don't want me to.
Ah. 12 inches of meat. Call that halfway to a good time.
And she trusted me anyway.
Well, trust is a bit of a strong word, Carlos. Ah, so that's how you break into a secret fridge place. You just fucking punch a computer and it'll let you in. Surely he won't catch me through here. Can't believe that worked.
You're gonna be okay, Jill.
Hey, Jill. Have some drugs. They make me feel better about life. Although, don't you need to get vaccinated before you get infected? You know, because otherwise it just makes everything worse.
Only a day away. There's still people in the city. You think Uncle Sam gives a shit? Fuck. Here they come. You sit tight. I got this. You better grab some gear. It sounds like there's a lot of them out there.
I need more brulette.
I'm gonna try to lower the window shutters. The less entry points, the better.
How do we do that?
I'll try hacking into the hospital security system. Keep them off me in the meantime.
Look, if these people wanted healthcare, they wouldn't have been born in America. Funnily enough, also, if they didn't want me to shoot them, they wouldn't have been born in America. It's a
now the fun shit.
It's a bit of a wide-ranging solution to things. Maybe I should put more effort into protecting my minions. That's not the word I'm looking for. Valuable bait. Closer. Oh yeah, friends. Maybe I should stop my friends from getting murderized. That's fine. If they wanted to live, they would have... There's a point. Amber, since you're the resident autism explainer here, how do promotions work? Like, is it a leveled system or is it like chess where you cross the board and get to become a queen? Must be somewhere. Thank you for the detailed tips and helpful advice, Mr. Explainer. Promotion according to Antifax is upset. That's clever. Getting distracted and murdered by a fucking beta. That's not clever. But yeah, it's like the trans agenda. I get 50 quid for every time J.K. Rowling gets an angry tweet about me.
I'm gonna try to lower the window shutters. The less entry points, the better.
How do we do that?
I'll try hacking into the hospital security system. Keep them off me in the meantime.
Although, I'm going to court gamer controversy now. If I lived in the same setting as fucking Umbrella Corps and their viruses, I would probably be an anti-vaxxer as far as anything they make goes. Like, best case scenario, they intend for it to make you better and it just doesn't work and turns you into some sort of monster. Worst case scenario, they intend for it to make you into some kind of monster and you just turn into a meat explosion. To be honest, for me, it's not even the zombie virus. It's that they are really bad at containing all their shit. Like, if I can't trust them to keep a virus in a sealed lab, then how on earth can I trust them to not mix up their virus and vaccine syringes? I'm glad these extra squishy zombies are here. To be honest, my dude, I don't trust Blue Umbrella either. Nothing personal, it's just they don't have honest faces. Ooh, pockets. I can use these for... I mean, sure, they claim to be ex-Umbrella who are friendly and trustworthy now, honest. But I'm not sure if I believe them. I mean, like, if I was an evil scientist working for Umbrella, the first thing I'd do is say, oh no, I'm good actually, look, I've got all these vaccines. It's like, what are they gonna do? Say, no, I don't want the vaccine to your horrible diseases? It's a captive market, my dude. I trust everybody except for Amber, and I don't trust Blue Umbrella. Oh my god, it makes sense now. Amber, you are Blue Umbrella.
Yes,
So sneaky, you dickhead. I don't let you swear because I don't know how auto mod works and Twitch just says no swearing. So yeah, mind the fucking profanity, people. Creativity is for nerds, just say fuck a lot. Suck my zombies.
Carlos, you all right?
Not even close, but at least it's all right. I'm coming back.
Carlos, my dude, why you gotta be saying it's over? I'm practically asking for Nemesis to burst through the thing. If they didn't want me to tear up the hospital, they wouldn't have given me explosives in a hospital. Happy ending, hooray. Hate to say it, but I would still shag Zombie Carlos. I hate to say it because I'm pretty sure it's already like been done, but someone's got to make like a mashup New Vegas slash Skyrim intro video thing. Make some more bullet. Oh, a new pistol. Nah, I don't like burst fire. Because I'm allergic to fun.
Morning, sunshine.
You saved my life.
I sure as shit didn't. That was all Carlos. He carried you here and he treated you himself, crazy bastard.
Where is he?
He went underground. Barred stockpiled the vaccine enough to give the city some hope.
He thinks he can do this by himself. I'm going after him.
Wait, did you see the broadcast? They're gonna blow the city sky high. I'm trying to get a hold of someone, anyone with the clearance to stop it.
Hey you, you're finally awake. How about that? You were trying to cross the border, right? Walked into that Legion ambush, same as us and that thief over there. I had to go rooting around in your noggin for some of the metal, so why don't you go have a look? See if I put you back together, right? I almost blew the city, but my knees got tired. How nice of Carlos to just stockpile all these random wooden crates around for us after blowing up all the other ones. I love stabbing people.
Nikolai's work.
Ah yes, only Nikolai knows how to shoot somebody in the head. Fuck you, Dawes, if you wanted some, Aha. Dank Kush. My favorite. There's a handy dandy crate which I can't reach because apparently Jill can't climb over a waist high wall. Makes sense, that is just how cops be. Hey, wait a second. I know how to unlock the safe now. 9 and 3. Haha. I'm inside of it. And they say it's hard to be a monster fucker. God damn it, Carlos, did you have to loot that thing for it before I could get to it? And yes, that was Carlos, not me, because I, like, wasn't paying attention during Carlos's segment and never got around to fetching that. Right, back to the records room to dump some of my superfluous shit. And then I can get me some high-grade ammo. Or high-grade gunpowder. That's not the records room. Oh, I haven't even touched the crawl space yet because my pockets are too full of stuff. Yeah, I don't need the grenade launcher because I can deal with betas using the shotgun. Let's check the staff room. Why you gotta be popping up like that? Don't you know this is a no jump scare household? See, this guy gets it. He gets up in a nice leisurely manner. Be more like that guy. So there's still some crap in the linen room and the treatment room. Fuck it, let's roll. Pretty sure I heard something behind me there, but if I ignore it, then it doesn't exist. Right, there's a point. Do I have the thing to mix? I do not. And that is the top floor, 100% done with. Stop off to dump my shit in the records room. And then we can finally do some crawling around, which Billy is so interested in. Anyway, excuse me. Oh, and just a quick save in case something pops out behind me while I'm crawling through the crawl space and makes me go, ah!
I think I can squeeze by.
Gratuitous arse shot. Alright, it's not too bad. They call it
guaranteed to give you a headache.
The overcompensator. So Jill, mate, you vault over that, dead simple, but you can't go back the other way. Jill, mate, like, why are you this way, Jill? Don't trust that teddy bear. It has a face of dishonesty and lies. God damn, I'm missing all the useful stuff. Ooh, what's this dossier say? Yeah, just the nurse's journal. Who cares about what nurses think during a big pandemic? Call me Boris, because all medical professionals can suck my Johnson. Sorry, you've lost your not being dead privileges. I have unlocked all the things. Delicious acid. How? Carrying out grenades when I don't even have a grenade launcher. So vulnerable. I hope nothing attacked me in this elevator.
How is it no one in the hospital ever noticed all this?
Yeah, pro tip to all my hospital worker friends. Just start opening random doors. You know, for the shits and giggles. Bag. Where? I've got the fuses from the sub-generators. I bet that's not going to be a thing I have to do soon. Everyone loves inventory management, right? Good, I'll keep doing it then. Yeah, so I've got a bit of healing and a lot of killing power. And no key item to carry around yet. Oh, thanks for the follow, King of Oats. Sorry I didn't notice for like ages. It's not that I don't care, I just don't pay attention to you people. That came out sounding a bit more dickheady than I felt like. Hey Nikki, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey Nikki. Shock, betrayal, anyway. Hey, my dude, could you not? Right, fuse number 3 get. I might finish this in under 5 minutes, I might not. I'm not, like, trying to. Murdering folks like that is why they call me the Bernie Bernie Oofouch Lady. They aren't very good at names. Right, I'm pretty sure I've already failed to make it to the 5 minute mark. Let's see if I can do this before I lose interest. Might help if I actually, like, paid attention to where the fuse boxes were. Pimp my shotgun. Yeah, that's going to be trouble. Yeah. There we go. Yeah, more pistol bullets. Because that keeps the option open of using my other, my fancy gunpowder up for like fancy stuff. So where have I not paid attention to where a fuse box might be? Bet it's somewhere blindingly obvious. Right. So got that one. I've got that one. There's a fuse box in here that I just wandered straight past. Oh hey, a memo. Remember kids, just get rid of all the oldies in your sample size. Surely that won't bias your results or anything like that. Quick save because I don't trust this game. And let's jog over to the lift. Oh god, you dickheads.
Shit, he got away. What is he doing in here?
Nikolai was definitely spying on us and selling the information for cash money. You have me at ass.
Then let's not waste one more second.
This way.
But I'm afraid we're going to have to call it here. Because it's been a couple of hours and I have got light evening stuff to do. So thank you all for joining me. Thank you to King of Oats for joining the channel as well. Or following the channel. Joining the cult. And yeah, I would keep playing because we're moderately close to the end. But I'd rather stop now, come back next week and be sure to have a decently sized stream to finish it all off on. Which just coincidentally means that right now I get to go have something to eat. So yeah, it's been fun y'all, and I hope to see as many of you as possible next week. Right. Bye.